Henriette from Scandinavian today, and I'm going to show you how I make my favorite Danish apple cake. It is called herregårdsæblekage in Danish, and it will translate to manor apple cake. And it's similar to a pie, an American apple pie, but it's not quite the same. I'm going to use Granny Smith apples for it, so hopefully you will also like it. In fact, my beer company, they all love it. And I do too. So let's get going. Here are the ingredients for my Danish apple cake. I am going to use 2 cups of flour. I have 13 tablespoons of butter. I'm going to use a pinch of salt, 1 egg, and sugar is about 4 ounces. And I'm also going to use 2 tablespoons of heavy cream. And the filling, it's about, here I'm going to use 5 large apples. You need about 2 pounds of apples. Of course, I'm going to peel them and core them. Then I'm going to use 1/3 cup of sugar, 1/3 cup of raisins, and also about 1/2 cup of chopped almonds. And the topping is going to be about 1/2 cup of chopped almonds, about I have 6 tablespoons of butter, and then I have sugar, it's about 1/2 cup of sugar. I'm going to mix all that up. So here the flour, sugar, and salt has already been mixed up. And now let's add the butter. I chopped it up. So just mix it in. So I crumbled the butter thoroughly, adding the 2 tablespoons of cream and also the 1 whole egg. And I'm going to let it all rest for about 1 hour before I can roll it out. As you can see, now all sticks together. I'm going to put in the refrigerator for the next hour. Now the Danish apple cake is similar to an apple pie, but we bake it in a spring form. So I have to roll out the dough now for the form. So first I'm going to do the bottom part. And of course I need 2 pieces like this, because I also need a top part which has to be the same size. Okay, here we are. Perfect. I am going to make 1 more circle. And I roll out the 2nd circle. After this, I have to roll out for the side of the form. It needs to be just a little bit bigger. It's almost the correct size now. Let's see, put this on top. And yes, we have it. And here I'm going to roll out for the side of the form. So of course it can be a long, you know, a roll, and then I have to roll it out afterwards with a rolling pin to fit the form. Let's see, it might almost be enough now. It has to be as long as the form.
use the rolling pin to make it wide enough. So here we have the form ready for the apple filling. Here we have the apples mixed with sugar, raisins, and chopped almonds, and I can pour it in the form, and then we can bake it. So I put it on the lid, and of course on top of this I now have to add the sugar almond topping. So the topping for is going to be remonce. In Danish we say remonce, I guess it's remonce in English. And here's soft butter. I add the chopped almonds. And of course also the sugar. It was half a cup of chopped almonds. And here we have the topping going on. And I had to spread it all over. And it's ready to go in the oven in a cup, just a couple of seconds, I guess. Okay, let's stick it in. I all finished. It's golden on top, and it was in the oven for about 55 minutes at a degree of 395. Uh-oh. The apple cake is still sizzling hot. And I'll take the outside off. Here you see my absolutely delicious Danish herregårds æblekage. And I can't wait to get a bite because I know it's so good. But I have to let it cool down, of course. So I can finally get to taste my delicious Danish æblekage. Herregårds æblekage. And here we have a nice piece. And here you see a nice slice of my Danish herregårds æblekage. So let's get a bite. I love the crunchiness of the almonds in the cake, and of course also the flavor of the apples and the raisins. It's just a wonderful combination. I hope you also enjoy it. Happy holidays, good Yule, Merry Christmas, skål to everybody, and please subscribe to our channel. We do appreciate your support. Thank you.